43. Europe straight up the field, bumped into his own man. Quickly grabbed the football, he put down at the 50-yard line. Eric Edwards, perhaps the most dominant player in the game today, especially on, if you look at defensive play, which has dominated so far. Now, the question for Bishops is, can the offense get some dominant play from this man, Jim Murphy, the quarterback?
Well, they showed some spark in that last series, hitting Masaki Kono over the middle. Not great numbers, 2 of 12, 27 yards, but all it's going to take is one play.
First and 10 from the 51. The toss goes to Claude Sereno, had trouble handling it at first. He put his head down.
Number 39, Jeff Roberts, straight ahead for about two.
And the tackle's made by Peter Payne.
Number 28, Mark Morrison with the tackle.
Well, Bishop's not known for running. You see they pull Joey Sabo, tries to kick outside, and then Jeff Roberts comes inside. Well, I'll tell you what, that's tough running inside.
Claude Sereno, 38, started the game at tailback for Bishops. He is not in there now, and we'll check on his condition for you as Jeff Roberts takes his place. Gain of a couple, and is now second and eight from the Bishops' side of midfield at the 53. Murphy steps up in the pocket. Now over the middle, complete to Tom Hart. And Hart has a first down as he's tackled by Chris McCormick. Hart's been the big receiver when they've managed to complete the passes.
Nice job by Jim Murphy. They got a blitz. You see Boone come into the right, and then he steps up into the pocket, throws a strike to Tom Hart, does a nice job of coming back for the football, trying to avoid there. Pretty good crack by Chris McCormick. Coughs the ball up, but the official rules of the ball or the ground caused the fumble.
Two injured players now for Bishops. The man who caught the pass, Tom Hart, is shaken up, as is Mike McCarthy, the running back. Hart took a pretty good shot there.
Tom Hart, over the past 4 years, has been one of the steadiest receivers in the country out of Fredericton High School. Had 21 receptions this year.
So Val Amigo checks into the football game, number 82.
First and 10 for the Gators, 37.
Actually, he's wearing number 89. Switch numbers for the game. Movement early, and this is Amigo with the carry. But there was early movement on both sides, and I think this might be procedure against Bishops.
Val Amigo has to be one of the biggest running backs in college football. 6'5", 240 pounds.
And we'll get the call from Bob Butler.
Offside, Queens, first down repeated.
So it'll be first and five for the Bishops Gators after Queens is called for offside. And now the ball is at the Queens 32-yard line with 2:18 to play in the first half. What a huge backfield they have there now for the Bishops Gators. Claude Sorrent has checked back into the game, number 38. Option. Here's Sorrent with some room. Sorrent up the sidelines, finally forced out of bounds. As up there to help on the stop was Mark Morrison, number 28, but not before Claude Sorrent checked back into the football game and got a first down.
Now, did you see the block that Kent Rowell? He came in a fullback. The lead blocker, number 78, at the bottom of your screen, he just made a great block, actually, number 32, Mark Johnson. And so Johnson really couldn't get around and take care of his responsibility with his primary contain. Good blocking downfield by Jonas Raymond as well.
The gain was 12. It is now first and 10 from the Queens 20. 2:12 to play in the first half. Murphy. Kind of a hitch screen complete out there to David Butler. And Butler is close to another first down, tackled by Joel Dagnoni. That was a great play, Jimmy, well executed.
Yeah, very nice, a nice quick hitch outside, and then Butler cuts it back inside and then takes it out. Jim Murphy, three-step drop, now he comes inside and then he goes out again. And just a shoestring tackle by Braden Dent.
Gain was 8, second and 2 now, from the 12. Busting it up inside is Jeff Roberts. Roberts has the first down, and Bishop's is down to about the two.
Boy, this hole really opens up for Bishop's. Valamigo, the lead blocker, number 89, kicks out. And then you see Roberts takes it up inside.
Again, working without a huddle. First and goal from the two. Murphy with the toss to Roberts. Outside, and a great defensive play is made there as up to make the stop was Mike Boone, the linebacker. And looked like Jeff Roberts was headed for the end zone.
Well, Mark Johnson, who's got contained, the outside linebacker, did a pretty good job of turning that play back inside so that Mike Boone, a linebacker, can scrape across and make that tackle. And Mike Boone's calling a timeout.
And checking into the football game for Bishop's, a couple of big fellas, including Eric Edwards, the linebacker, who comes in to play offense when they get down to the goal line.
Well, I'm sure that's what Mike Boone saw. And this is a pretty good job by Mike to call the timeout, go over to the sidelines, talk to Doug Hargraves, and also talk to the defensive coordinator, Bob Mullins.
They've got lots of their defense in there, does Bishop's. They've got defensive lineman Kent Rao in there. They've got linebacker Eric Edwards in there as well.
Option. That's exactly right. We're looking for option. So, probably only have four guys.
Yeah, he's got to take the pitch.
Take the pitch, that's all right.
Huh?
Linebacker's pretty straight.
Okay, well, he's got to go to the pitch. We've got a straight cover and score, guys. Let's go. 80 cover zero, 82 cover zero.
Okay, now they think that Bishop's gonna come out and try and run option. You hear Doug Hargraves saying that the defensive end has to take the pitch man, their secondary man, Joel Dagnone, he's gonna have to fill, as well the linebacker, Mike Boone's gonna have to scrape across to take the quarterback if he decides to keep it.
Roberts lost a couple on that last carry, second and goal from the four. Here comes the option. No, he's going back the other way, and Jim Murphy is dropped. An outstanding defensive play by Mark Johnson. Murphy tried to reverse his field, and right away Johnson was in his face.
And you know, it worked for Queens. Everything they did, they had everybody taken care of, and then Murphy realizes, uh-oh, nothing doing going to the front side. He decides to turn around, and then Mark Johnson, the Czech linebacker, backside, makes a great tackle.
And now Greg Hiscox will attempt a field goal from 14 yards out. And it's a fake. Alain Baudouin, I believe that is running the offense. And now there's an offside call. There's a flag down, and we'll see what the call is. And we're told that that's an intentional play by Bishop's trying to draw the other team offside as they move up into their offense. Baudouin simply calls plays and the ball is not snapped.
That's what he's handling, relax.
Okay, everybody's back here.
Okay, now can we get back on?
He's talking about how the quarterback, number 84 in that case, Alain Baudouin, went up underneath the center, then took his hands out and went back underneath again. That's a legal procedure.
And that's the call from Bob Butler.
The call against the Gators, backing them up.
Procedure is the call against Bishop's.
And Peter Payne was the linebacker who recognized that. Now watch, you see how he's got his hands underneath, pulls them back out again. You cannot do that. That is a legal procedure. And then Peter Payne comes up there and touches Chris Doucette, saying you can't do that.
So now the field goal attempt will come from 18 yards out. It is up and good. Some intrigue at the goal line. It results in a Greg Hiscox field goal. And now it is a 2-point lead for Queens. We had a little bit of everything down there, Jamie.
Everything, guys. We had option, we had fakes, we had everything, guys. I guess it's playoff time. The Dunsmore Cup, you're going to pull out all your stops and try and go for everything.
I can't think of a more appropriately named football player than Peter Payne.
There was a guy a couple years ago played for Mount A. I think his name was Scott Massacre. That's another great one. He's a defensive player, so some aptly named football players in CIAU.
First and 10 from the 35-yard line. 109 to play in the first half. Queens leads by two. Here's Brad Elberg on the carry. And Elberg has his legs cut out from underneath him by Christian Day.
By number 44, Brian Wardrop, and 99, Christian
Brian Day. Wardrop also helped make the stop.
Gain of five.
It's been the workhorse in the Queens running game, 11 carries so far today. I'm a little bit surprised that Queens is not running their two-minute offense. Lightning offense right here. I guess they are going to be happy to go into their dressing room with a 2-point lead.
gain of six at second and four. Here's Elberg again, and Elberg is stacked up. Joel Kruzich finished him off. 44 seconds to play in the first half.
They're gonna be coming, okay? I think they'll be coming with a couple of this one.
Doug Hargraves expects Bishop to go for the punt block, and that would seem to be a reasonable idea at this point.
Yeah, they will be coming. You see, as Brad Elberg tries to take that off tackle and cuts it back inside.
Where are we, Calgary? And speaking of Calgary, the Dinosaurs will play UBC later on today for the Hardy Cup, the Canada West Football Championship. It's conference final weekend. All four games being played today, as the road to the Vanier Cup narrows considerably today. We'll be down to four teams by tonight.
And the weather here, even though it's cold, they say in Vancouver, it's been 28 hours of torrential rain. So less than ideal conditions to play out in Vancouver, but I understand Vince Danielson will start that football game. He was injured last week. They said he was 50-50 whether he would play this week, but he is going to get the nod to start today.
And we'll have scores and highlights of the games for you coming up at halftime. Jamie Galloway is back to punt with 44 seconds to play in the first half. 10 men on the line now for the Bishop's Gators. Here they come. And they don't get close. Galloway's low driving punt is taken by Matt Legg at the 38. And Legg gets up to the 45. Now 34 seconds to play in the first half as Don Warwick made the stop.
You know, 34 seconds is a lot of time for Bishop's offense. I mean, this is a team that can score very quickly.
After a string of eight straight incompletions in the first half, Jim Murphy's getting a little better, now 4 of 14, but still not anything close to what he'd like to see.
They only need 30 yards to get in field goal range, so more than enough time.
First and 10 from the 45, out of the shotgun. Here's Murphy looking deep, and it's picked off. Intercepted by Joel Dagnone, and Dagnone's got some room to run inside Bishop's territory before he is finally forced out of bounds by David Butler. Well, you talk about time, 24 seconds left. Queens has the ball down at the 48-yard line, and the Golden Gales might be able to strike here.
Well, the runner receiver straight down the field, and he was trying to hit Jonas Raymond in that level two area. You see number 88, but overthrown Joel Dagnone, who plays that center field spot, had seven interceptions
Good
on the
job,
season,
Joel.
Comes down with another key
Good
one.
Good job, Joel. Joel Dagnone.
First and 10 from the Bishop's 48, 24 seconds to play. Pendergast to throw. Jovanic has it, and he's dragged down there by Martin Pepe after a gain of about six.
I'll tell you what, that is a dangerous pass at this time in a football game, that long out sideline. You know, you make about 6 yards in that. Awful dangerous. If Pepe steps in front, it's a TD.
Now 12 seconds to play in the first half. Pendergast, his receiver fell, and it goes incomplete. He was looking for Ed Kidd, but Kidd slipped in that sloppy area of the field. So now 4 seconds to play from the 42-yard line. That would be a very long field goal for Jamie Galloway. It would be an attempt of about 49 yards.
Well, I saw him attempt one earlier in the pregame warm-up from 52 yards. Now, that's with nobody pressuring you and got all the time in the world to sit back there. They've decided they are not going to attempt that right now. They're probably going to just try and... Oh, and I hold it. I see Jamie Galloway coming onto the field.
Play of game, ref. Come on. Oh, come on.
And they've called timeout, so Galloway will give it a try. I love kicks in the warm-up. Talk about a useless stat.
Yeah, right.
Every field goal kicker in organized football is hit from 55 yards in the warm-up.
Cover it!
And that's a great point that is yelled in from the Queen's sideline to cover it should it be missed.
I think that was an old line when Tony Fritsch was kicking with the Houston Oilers and they brought him over from Austria. He was kicking them from 50 yards open. In his first game, he had to kick a 3.5-yard convert. And he said, nobody told me there were 11 guys on the other side of the line of scrimmage trying to break my neck.
Well, Jamie Galloway, I'm sure, is well aware of it. This field goal attempt will come from the 49-yard line. Don Simpson is back to field it should he miss. And he'd have a lot of running room. High snap. And Galloway's kick isn't close. It bounces at the 5, and here comes Don Simpson. Simpson looking for some blocks. He's got a couple up the sidelines, and he won't get far. Peter Payne finally drives him out of bounds up around the 25-yard line. It's the end of the first half, and it's close. Queen leads Bishop 8-6. Coming up, a TSN update, Jim's Excellent Adventure, and more. You're watching the CIAU on TSN.
Check the map.
Cancel that order, guy.
All right.
Yeah.
Let's eat.
You want a Coke?
No, make it a Pepsi.
Well, what's the diff?
You said that. What?
The difference is one tastes better.
This one.
You chose Pepsi.
The majority of soft drink users tested prefer the taste of Pepsi over Coke Classic.
You want sausage or pepperoni?
What's the diff?
Time magazine called him the master funny man of the age. Now, for the first time ever, the legendary king of comedy and music is captured on video in The Best of Victor Borge, Act 1 and Act 2.
Pardon me, madam, are you laying eggs?
You get two outrageous performances over 90 minutes of the king of comedy.
Isn't it a shame these big fat opera singers always lean against the pianos and bend them?
Recorded live, this collector's edition of Priceless Comedy is a must for every Victor Borge fan. It's the incomparable Victor Borge in his best-loved, most heartwarming comedy performance of all time. Best of Victor Borge, Act 1 and Act 2, from Quality Video, in stores now.
Hi, everyone, and welcome back to our TSN Control Center in Toronto. I'm Chris Seedens. We'll send you back to more of the Dunsmore Cup in Lennoxville, Quebec. Queens against Bishop. Second half action coming up in just a moment. First of all, this is a big college football weekend in Canada. We have a first quarter score, actually no score to tell you about. In the first quarter at the Sky Dome in Toronto, it is the Ontario Conference Final, the Yates Cup Western against Guelph. A great matchup, no score, early first quarter. This game just got underway at 2 o'clock Eastern Time. And another big game this afternoon has the Atlantic Conference Final. Mount Allison playing against St. Mary's. That is in Halifax, of course. Mount Allison looking for a second straight berth in the Vanier Cup this year. Big afternoon and evening in the NHL. 10 games in all, 2 this afternoon. Brett Hull has scored for the Blues, his 6th of the season. St. Louis up on the Flyers, 1-0 in the second. And the Hawks on a goal by Jeremy Roenick up on the Nordique, 1-0 in the first period as well. The Bombers playing against Ottawa in a big game this weekend. First place in the East Division on the line. More from Lisa Bowes.
Oh yeah, it's cold out here too. It's definitely cold.
November in Manitoba brings out the best in the Bombers. It's playoff time and the weather becomes an ally.
For that victory come Sunday.
The story of practice this week has not been the temperature, but rather the quarterbacks. Despite 4 straight wins under Danny McManus, interim head coach Urban Bowman is putting the ball back in the hands of Matt Dunnigan.
I was just, like I said before, a substitute teacher, and they're trying to do a good job. And, you know, I did have some success, but I had help from other guys, too. So hopefully that success will rub off, and Matt will be able to win the game on Sunday.
So you don't mind stepping to the sideline?
Not at all, no. I mean, because if it was something that they just sprung on you right away, there might be, you know, I might have a little different opinion. But, no, it's something that they explained to me before even the situation came up. So I knew all along eventually this day would come.
It hasn't caused any animosity on the football team. I think it's caused concern, relative to continuity with the football team and keeping momentum going. And hopefully I can continue to do that.
The Bombers forked out the cash to acquire Dunnigan's services, and they want to get their money's worth. He is a big money player who is expected to come through in the big games. Despite missing 6 of the last 7 games, Dunnigan remains the number one pivot. So is he 100% injury free?
No, ready to go.
No matter who starts at quarterback, expect this to be a defensive struggle. Odds are in favor of the Bombers because they have had a chance to practice all week in these adverse weather conditions. And they know that a win on Sunday against Ottawa means home field advantage in the Eastern Final, November 22nd. Lisa Bowes, TSN, Winnipeg.
Thank you, Lisa. We now have a final, actually a halftime scoring from St. Mary's. It is St. Mary's up on Mount Allison, 15-10 there at the half. Back to Lennoxville, Quebec in just a moment.
If you're between 50 and 75, Norwich Union will insure you for life with no medical exam or health questions.
Even with my heart condition, I didn't need a medical to be insured.
And they didn't ask us any health questions.
Your guaranteed life insurance can cost as little as $20 a month. Depending on your age and the premium you choose, you could be covered for up to $25,000. And in case of a fatal accident, your benefit triples up to $75,000.
With the guaranteed life insurance plan, I'll have the affordable protection I need, and my premiums will never go up.
Call this number now for your free personal enrollment kit. You're under no obligation, and no salesperson will visit. If you're between 50 and 75, you're automatically approved with no medical exam. Just call 1-800-263-9899. An operator is standing by to take your call now. That's 1-800-263-9899. Ask for operator 403.
Queens leads Bishops 8-6 after 30 minutes of play in the Ontario-Quebec final here in Lennoxville. Well, now, to get to Lennoxville, you have to go through Kingston. And we happen to run into a few of our buddies from Queens. And so did our pal Jim. His journey to Queens on this week's edition of
Jim's Excellent Adventure!
Errol. It's time now for Jim's Excellent Adventure in search of Queens. Errol.
I'm here in Kingston, Ontario, home of Queens University and the defending OQIFC champions, the Golden Gales. Now, there are no signs telling me how to get to Queens, but I got my map and I know I'm getting closer because there's Princess Street. Now that I found Princess, I'm looking for... There it is! Earl! Aha, King Street. Now we all know where there's a king, there's a queen. According to the map, this must be the building. All right, let's see now. There's Arch Street. I came off of Arch and Barry and Lower University Avenue. You know, I think I'm on the campus of Queens University, but I'm not quite sure because I'm not a very good map reader. And when I look in this building, there are really no markings on the wall to let me know that I'm at Queens. And this is an old university founded in 1842, but this building seems to be a little bit too new to be part of the Queens campus. So, let's take a look around and see if we can find any physical evidence that we are on the campus of Queens University. Here at the gymnasium, I'm looking for a sign, just any sign that I'm at Queens University. And you know what? I'm just looking for one sign, just one clue.
As far as Jim's concerned, he never did find Queens University. If only he'd had some sort of sign.
Next week on Jim's Excellent Adventure, it's the best of Jim.
This is so easy. I could do this in my sleep.
The critics are calling it unbelievable.
Transporter room, beam me up, Scotty.
Like moving said Rolling Stone.
I just ran up all those stairs so we could get up here to see this telescope and we could see the full moon in Halloween. They tell me it's spectacular this time of year.
This time, Jim's outdone himself.
Who? Who will come?
That's next week on Jim's Excellent Adventure.
Cue the band. The Queen's Golden Gale Marching Band. Don't forget, the best of Jim's Excellent Adventure. Now available on CDs everywhere.
Everybody's different. Different looks, different tastes, different lifestyles. That's why Geo offers you a choice, like the import-inspired Geo Metro, Geo Storm, and Geo Tracker. So pick your favorite and get to know Geo right around the corner at your Chevrolet Geo dealers.
Now, McCain brings you French Fries, the next generation. McCain Golden Crisp, the natural taste of fresh Canada number one potatoes, locked in with a delicate crispy coating. So when you crunch through that crispy coating, you'll taste the best fries that ever came out of an oven. McCain Golden Crisp, you cross tracks and spirals. McCain Golden Crisp, the next generation.
We got no shot at getting through this, Jamie. Highlights of the first half. Let's talk first of all about defense and the outstanding play of Eric Edwards.
Well, that's what it was, Gordon. It was all defense in the first half. Look at the score, 8-6. Eric Edwards, one of the best linebackers in the country. He picks off Tim Pendergast in the first play, and that turned it into actually a field goal for Bishopston. They got on the board first because of Eric Edwards' interception.
Now, when you talk about outstanding defensive plays as well, Mark Johnson, number 32, turned into a great one here.
Well, when you're down the goal line, Bishop decide they're going to try and run option. Jim Murphy doesn't see what he likes when they go to option, and then Mark Johnson, the backside linebacker, comes in and stuffs him for a loss, and that was a big defensive play for Queens.
What do you expect here in the second half?
I think you're going to have to see both teams open it up a little bit more right now. They're starting to get conservative in the second quarter. They got to start throwing the ball a little bit more effectively. And I think we're going to see a little bit more offense in the second half.
All right, it's time to go to commercial. And as we do, and a one, and a two, and a one, two, three.
Rocket fuel.
Play Rocket Fuel Touchdown and you could win up to $25,000.
Are you still living with this nightmare? Over a million motorists have said never again. They've switched to Triple Edge, and the difference is amazing. Triple Edge is the world's first high-tech windshield wiper. It clears, it cleans, it wipes dry, all in a single pass. But that's not all. Triple Edge wipers won't tear, dry rot, or freeze to your windshield. They're made from DuPont Nordel, the same material used in 50,000-mile radial tires. Triple Edge gives you visibility through the heaviest downpour. It whisks away snow and ice. Even mud is no match for Triple Edge.
The day after I got my Triple Edge wipers, we had a big snowstorm with blowing sleet and wind. Everybody had trouble seeing except me. My visibility was beautiful.
No noise, no streaking, no smearing, no tearing. Custom fit to install in seconds. They're the last windshield wipers you'll ever buy. Triple Edge is available at participating Woolco, London Drugs, Home Hardware, Overweighty and Save-On Foods, Beaver Lumber, and Kmart.
Okay, Wendell, let's see what you got. That's unbelievable.
It's all on the stick.
Should have had these in Montreal.
It's a Sherwood.
Where'd you get it?
It's free, with five chunky soup labels.
It's free?
Yeah, it's free.
I want everyone here tomorrow with five chunky soup labels.
Call now for your free Wendell Clark Sherwood hockey stick.
Well, 131 net yards for Bishops, 126 for Queens. Indicative of the close score that we have, 8-6 Golden Gales after 30 minutes.
Yeah, also indicative of a tight defensive game right now. You know, we're looking at the number one and number two defenses in the conference. A little bit surprising, though, that Queens has come out and played great defense in the secondary so far. You know, they're number six in the OQIFC, but they're playing the top of their game this afternoon. Ian Breck, the head coach of the Bishop's Gators, getting his charges back out onto the field. You can see he's wearing those receiver gloves, so it tells you what kind of a program they have here. He likes to throw the football.
It's a chilly day here, -5 at kickoff. It feels a little colder than that now. The wind's died down and it stopped snowing. That's the two bits of good news. The bad news is it gets kind of dark early this time of year and there's no lights at this field. Yeah. So if overtime is required, we could have a problem. On the campus of Bishop's University in Lennoxville, Quebec, in the Eastern Townships. And what a gorgeous area this is. And what enthusiastic fans these are. And there's been some theft down at the one end of the end zone. That's what the fans are cheering about. Some enthusiastic Bishop's fans have stolen the colors of Queens. Ah, jocularity. Bishops will kick it off to begin this second half. Queens will get it back, leading by a couple. Queens put together the only scoring drive of the game in the first quarter. It was a very impressive drive, but we haven't seen much since.
No, we haven't. You know, that was the longest drive so far today. 8 plays in that scoring drive. 2 passing, the rest of them were on the ground. Doug Hargrave's been in many games of this importance in the past. Won a Vanier Cup with Queens in 1978. And won this game in a tight one last year, 34-31.
Greg Hiscox to kick it off. A low driving kick that is taken by Brad Elberg at the 15. Elberg breaks away. He's got room across midfield. Elberg. Only one man to beat. Europe dives. Touchdown. Brad Elberg on the opening kickoff of the second half. Takes the opening kickoff, 95 yards for a Queens touchdown. Absolutely sensational.
Brad Elberg has great speed. They say they clock him at 4-4, and you can see the kind of speed he has here when he pulls away, especially right here in the top of your screen. Number one, Tom Europe, who they say is another player who's got 4-4 speed. Looks like Europe's starting to catch him. The two number ones chasing each other down the field. And he manages to get into the end zone.
First time in the football game that Bishops had kicked off. And Queens took it back for a touchdown. With the convert to come, it's 14-6 in favor of Queens. Bishops may have stolen the colors, but right now the Golden Gaels have stolen the show.
No, I'm fine. We got a while. Yep. Doesn't matter.
And we have a delay as we wait for the convert. Brad Elberg will need a couple of moments to get his win as Tom Europe, who was the last man with a chance to catch Elberg, leaves the field.
And you know, Gore, this is the exact opposite of what happened in the very first game. We talked about the interception that Tom Europe ran back for a touchdown. The player that Pendergast is throwing the ball to is Elberg, and Elberg could not catch him. Here we had the reverse situation happen where Tom Europe could not catch Brad Elberg.
Galloway with the convert, and it is good. We've played all of 14 seconds in the second half. And here's what might very well be the play of the game.
And they say there's no substitute for speed. Elberg starts off to the right and then he cuts back, finds that little seam, and now it's just a foot race right here. Actually, a good block on the kicker, Greg Hiscox. And now Tom Europe, it looks like he's got a little bit of an angle. And makes that diving stab for his foot, but it was just a little bit too little. Looks like Brad Elberg has some rib problems. And I'm sure after that long run, he was breathing pretty hard, and they probably aggravated them a little bit.
Back deep for the Gators. Number 20, Tom Hart. Number 2, Masaki Kono. And number 17, Joel Cruz.
Brad Elberg has given his team a 9-point lead. It was the opening play of the second half. A kickoff return of 95 yards for a touchdown. We'll see what Bishops can do. Galloway's kick. Taken by Tom Hart at the 20. Hart looks for room, dances out close to the sidelines, but he's brought down there by Max Turner. So a more conventional kickoff return, this time by Tom Hart, and Bishops will take over first and 10 from about the 30-yard line.
Well, that Brad Elbert kickoff puts a little bit more pressure on Jim Murphy, quarterback. Not great numbers in the first half, only four completions of 15 attempts. In fairness to Jimmy, had a few dropped.
Mike McCarthy, the slot back, Jimmy, has a shoulder injury. And Claude Serena is now playing wide receiver. Here's the pass intended for Tom Hart. And that dropped into a pack of Queens defenders.
28, Mark Morrison. Second down.
Jim Murphy looking downfield, good protection. Trying to go for Tom Hart. You can see that number five coming off of that, Braden Dent. Breaks up the play.
Now second and 10 from the 31. This crowd still stunned by that 95-yard kickoff return for a touchdown to open the second half. Murphy steps up. As time looks over the middle, incomplete. David Butler couldn't make the catch. And again, a pass by Jim Murphy that probably should have been caught.
And you know, you have to give good credit to Queens defensive secondary. You know, they're doing a really good job here playing man coverage. James Patterson coming across the field. You know, that's tight coverage. You can't get any better than that.
Would have been a tough catch.
Yeah, Butler would have been a tough catch. Kind of stretching out, trying to haul that one in.
Greg Hiscox will punt for the eighth time today. Plenty of time and a nice high spiraling punt into this wind, taken by Mark Morrison at the 45. And this time the Bishop special teams come up quickly to make the tackle. Joel Kruzich makes the stop along with Danny Bohink, but it'll be great field position again for Queens. First and 10 from their own 53-yard line. A kickoff return for a touchdown has given the Golden Gales a 9-point lead over Bishop.
Tim Hortons has mealtime deals. So come on in for a super deal on our great selection of savory soups and chili too.
You've always got time, always got time for Tim Hortons.
Enjoy one of our soups with a tea biscuit, coffee and a donut for just $2.99. Or a heartwarming bowl of chili with a coffee, donut and a Kaiser for $3.99.
Always got time for Tim Hortons.
Soup's on, chili's hot.
Well, the special teams have given Tim Pendergast and the Golden Gales a little cushion.
Yeah, not as much pressure on Tim Pendergast now. We see his first half stats. 6 of 14, 49 yards, two interceptions. They don't look very good, but he had two big completions on their drive in the second quarter that resulted in a touchdown.
Two of his first four passes were picked off, but he's settled down since then. His team has the football first and 10 from its own 53-yard line. The lead ball, the lead back, Paul Kozak.
Right here. Good, number 75, Paul the Slapper Connery.
And the tackle is made by Paul Connery.
Going nowhere fast. Second down. Well,
now, when you're supposed to help out the stop is Christian Diggs.
Sorry, Gorb, when you're running option, there's supposed to be a read initially to the fullback. And if somebody's taking him, then in fact you take the ball back out and then you take your next read, who's the primary contain man. But that time, Tim Pendergast has handed the ball off and where he would have been more or better advised to run the option.
No gain, second and 10. Pendergast under pressure, throws to the flat and completes it out there to Rob Weir. But Weir is a couple yards short of the first down, as up to make the stop was Tom Ura.
Now that shows a little bit of inexperience on Rob Weir's part. You know, they're trying to roll out here. And when you're rolling out, the receiver's got to take the route downfield a little bit deeper because the quarterback has more time because he's getting outside. You can see Rob Weir makes his cut, makes the catch, but they're going to come up a yard and a half short. Rob Weir out of Oakville Trafalgar came to this program as a quarterback, as did Ed Kidd earlier, but they made him into a wide receiver.
And they'll have a look at this, but it's at least a yard short. This field's actually held up pretty well today, Jay. We were talking about how sloppy it might get, but it hasn't been bad.
Oh, I think it's because of the cold weather. I think the field is partly frozen right now.
Third down.
Third and a yard. In comes the short yardage team. Maybe even the punting unit. Yeah, they're going to punt. Jamie Galloway steps onto the field, and Queens will take no chances.
Now, this is a time when you might want to run a fake.
Back deep for the Gators, Kono, leg.
Well, if you're going to go for it, usually you'd go for it with your offense in there, but Jamie Galloway, the punter, is back there now for Queens. And the man to watch is Don Rorwick, number 35. If it's a direct snap. Kind of faked it. Galloway gets a nice high punt. Taken by Masaki Kono at his three. Kono with a burst of speed. And finally, he is cut down as Brad Dent got up to make the stop. Dent is hurt. Kono with a quick burst of speed got all the way up to the 20-yard line. And despite the fact that their team is down, the Bishop fans maintain the enthusiasm as Brad Dent gets a look from the athletic therapist from Queens, but he went down very quickly as he made the tackle on Masaki Kono. And it is cold, and every hit must feel that much tougher.
Well, Brad Dent makes the hit right coming in there, boom. I think he might have taken right a in knee the thigh. Yeah, I think he might have taken a knee to the side of the head. But you know, Masaki Kono, that's exactly how you're supposed to return punts. Take it straight up the field. You know, all that the coverage team is coming down. A lot of them haven't broken down yet. If you can bust it through that first wave, you've got a pretty good chance of making some good yardage. It's coming in there to the right of your screen. It looks like his head was behind him when he hit him, but
score a touchdown on the beat while I'm getting a drink.
I think he actually hit him right on the hip with his head. Let's hope it's not serious. Braden Dent, a defensive back for the Queens Golden Gales.
As Brad Dent is attended to by the staff from Queens, we'll take a break and return to Lenoxville, where the Golden Gales lead the Gators 15-6.
Getting to know you.
I drove literally every car in the same class, and it boiled down to I wanted a Geo Storm.
It makes me feel really good knowing I have a driver's side airbag.
There's 140 horses in here. Can you hello? Horses.
You don't have to be a race car driver to drive a Storm, but you sure feel like one.
Get to know the new 140 horsepower Geo Storm GSI. Right around the corner at your Chevrolet Geo dealers.
If this car had wings, it would fly.
Well, there's relief on the Queen sidelines as Brad Dent leaves under his own power. He seems to be all right, and the Bishop's Gators will take over first and 10 from their own 20-yard line. They trail this game by 9 with 11:52 to play
first
in the third quarter.
Gators at the 21.
Jim Murphy to throw on first down. Under pressure now, gets it out there looking for Tom Hart. But the play is broken up by Aaron Campbell, who timed his play perfectly to get there just as the ball arrived.
Yeah, Aaron Campbell has come in for the injured Brad Dent. It certainly doesn't waste any time in getting involved in the football game. Again, you can see problems with the footing again as Tom Hart slips a little bit. Really didn't have an effect. Pretty good pop.
And on a cold day like this, it hurt up here. Second and 10 from the 20. From the shotgun, here's Murphy. Time, and now Murphy pulls it down, he'll run. Murphy's got lots of room, a first down and more, all the way up to about the 40-yard line, stopped at the 39, as the stop is made by Max Turner.
Well, Gorman, you run a 6 defensive back package, and everybody's playing man coverage. Watch how all the linebackers, they start covering the backs, they start running out of their guys are turning, they don't have their heads looking at back at the quarterback. Murphy makes a great decision. He just sees that, hey, there's nobody there, I'm gonna just try and get as much yardage as I possibly can.
The gain was 17, first and 10 from the 38 for Bishops. Back to the ground they go, Claude Surratt. Surratt is stacked up quickly. The tackle is made by Mark Johnson, among others. Jamie left the game for a while in the first half, but has returned. He even plays some wide receiver in this offense.
Yeah, that was a little bit unusual, Claude Sarin. 8 carries, 52 yards. When you consider he only had 181 yards rushing in 7 games, not a bad afternoon.
On 2nd and 7 over the middle for Masaki Kono, but he can't make the tackle. He took a shot from Aaron Campbell.
Looking for number 2, Masaki Kono, number 24.
And Brad Dent says he's all right, but he looks a little worse for wear. Shaking off the cobweb.
Going over the middle to Masaki Kono. Just a little bit too high, and then Aaron Campbell comes in and lays a great lick on him.
It's been a problem today for Bishops, is hauling in those passes for Murphy. 9th punt of the game for Greg Hiscox. End over end punt, and it is taken. Finally there by Steve Jovanich, and Jovanich got just a couple. He was trying to induce Bishops into a no-yards call. Jim Georgitsis made the stop. Well, you mentioned earlier that this field is a little sloppy. If Sherbrooke gets the Pan Am Games in 1999, we are told that this field will have artificial turf. Sherbrooke bidding to host the Pan Am Games, and other cities from Canada bidding include Winnipeg. Can't find many areas nicer than this to hold them, though. 1st and 10 for Queens from the 40. Albert. Looked like he was about to break off tackle, but Brian Wardrop made a great stop.
I'll tell you, that's a great play by the linebacker, Brian Wardrop. You know, we've talked a lot about Eric Edwards, but watch Brad Elberg. Starts out to the right, you know, and then he sees that, hey, Wardrop's got the angle on. Now he cuts it back, but Wardrop makes a great recovery in sliding down and making that tackle. I mean, that is great defensive play.
The gain was 3 and a 2nd and 7. 9-12 to play here in the third quarter. And a quick drop play goes to Paul Kozan, and Kozan has a first down after a gain of about 12. Tackled by Christian Day.
It's a nice play. They take Brad Elberg, the tailback, and they set him over the tight end. Just at the top of your screen, looks like he's going to be sprint out action. Then they run the inside trap draw. And Paul Kozan played in Regina. Eric Edwards is having a fine game, but that time Paul Kozan gets the better of him. You don't see Eric Edwards miss too many tackles.
And Queens now has a 1st and 10 at the Bishops 54 over the middle, and they were looking there for the tight end, Dan McCullough, but McCullough couldn't haul it in as John Gooby clotheslined him at the last second. There is a flag down on the play.
Flag down.
9 Bishops on the quarterback.
Christian Day.
Ooh, that's a huge play.
Caught for roughing, Tim Pendergast.
Automatic first down for Queens. The ball now at the Bishop's 39-yard line. So instead of forcing Queens to punt, Bishops takes a roughing the quarterbacking call.
And you know something else here, Gord, the wind has shifted. It is now blowing in the face of Queens, blowing left to right.
Now 1st and 10 from the 39, thanks to the roughing the passer penalty. Side, they give the ball
number
off
20, Ed
to Ed Kidd, but Kidd lost a couple. Danny Bohink in to make the stop.
Now they're trying to run counter with the slot back, Ed Kidd. Full flow to the right and then counter back inside. Good job by the Bishop's defense to stuff that. You can see the snow now starting to fall a little bit heavier.
Yes, I'm becoming aware of that, old friend. Loss of a couple. And they give inside to Kozan. He's going nowhere. He got back to the original line of scrimmage. Gain of a couple as Danny Bohink again was in to make the stop. Well, with the wind changing direction, this kind of changes the philosophy for Queens. They might have attempted the field goal earlier, but they'd have to try it from about 46 now, and this would be a very long field goal. Ed Kidd is down now, and let's have a look at what happened to him. Down at the end of the play here, and Matt Legg jumped up and took a little shot at him, and actually as he was giving it back, it looked like Kidd might have caught his fingers in the mask. Everything must hurt on a day like today.
Well, Looks like he might have jammed his fingers on his left hand.
Number 20, head kid, the injured gold scale.
Got him up in the mask, I think.
Yeah.
Well, he thinks the field seems to be all right. Galloway will punt from the 54. 3 men back deep to receive for Bishop. Galloway low end over end punts, it bounces at the 20. Masaki Kono picks it up there and doesn't get far.
29 yards, taken by Kono, return of 7.
Rupp Thurger makes the stop. Bishop will have the ball back, trailing by 9 when we return to Lennoxville and the Ontario Quebec Final.
Check the map.
Cancel that order, guys.
All right.
Yeah.
Let's see. You want a Coke? No, I'm making a Pepsi. Well, what's the diff?
I can't believe you said that. What?
The difference is one tastes better.
This one.
You chose Pepsi.
The majority of soft drink users tested prefer the taste of Pepsi over Coke Classic.
You want sausage or pepperoni?
What's the diff?
We're back in Lennoxville, 7.5 minutes to play in the third quarter. 15-6 is the lead for Queens over Bishops. Stay tuned at the conclusion of today's game for the TSN Turning Point, brought to you by Sony.
Experience the thrill of the game with Sony Trinitron's One Gun Picture 2. A picture so real you'll catch all the action. It's worth its weight in gold.
Some people get all the breaks. Who's Charlie?
It's quite the logo on that cast.
That's backup quarterback Charlie Orkison, who is the object of the affections there. We are told on the Queen's sideline, or the Bishop's sideline. Bishop's now has it first and 10 from the 16-yard line. Under 7.5 to play here in the third quarter. Murphy over the middle looking for Jonas Raymond, and again, the pass falls incomplete.
And now they also have Jeff Roberts lined up at wide receiver. We saw Claude Sirin earlier. Jeff Roberts, who's been playing a little bit of tailback today as well, now playing wide receiver.
Last 6 passes by Murphy have fallen incomplete. The big play of this football game was the opening kickoff of the second half, taken back for a 95-yard touchdown by Brad Elberg of Queens. Murphy back across the field. Complete over there to Jonas Raymond. But he is stacked up quickly by a gang
Murphy
of Queens tacklers, and he is not close to the first down. Max Turner led the Queens wave of gales.
Well, Bishops want to give Jim Murphy a chance to throw to somebody quick if he can, but you know, the linebackers are spying Jonas Raymond. Then they let him go, and he's actually looking at throwing to the right. Then he comes back and throws to the left. But it's only a 5-yard reception, and then there's not much room for Jonas Raymond to turn it upfield as Joel Dagnoni comes in and makes the tackle.
And that will bring on Greg Hiscox for a 10th time today. Nice high punt. Great punt into the wind. Jovanich lost it. Falls on it before it was recovered by Chris Doucette, who was bearing down on it. What a great punt into that breeze. And yes, the weather is appropriate.
Yeah, I thought he'd be flying south at this time of year as we take a look at the goose. Oh, actually, it's a fan from Queens, from Bishops. I wouldn't put that on Queens.
You know what? That guy told me last night he was wearing a goose on his head, and I didn't believe him.
You better watch out. Somebody's liable to take a shot at him.
Me. First and 10 from the 49. The give goes to the lead back, Paul Beresford. And Beresford has about 4. Brian Wardrop in to make the stop.
Paul Beresford, another one of these Queens football players that came to this university as a quarterback out of high school. And he said he's played almost every position on this team except offensive line. Great crowd here this afternoon at Bishops.
Game was 3 at 2nd and 7. Here's Elberg, and what a great stop. Paul Connery jumps up to make the stop.
But the guy who made that play was Christian Dagg, number 99. Boy, he shot across. They're trying to run toss. where all the offensive lines reaching, they lead with the lead back to kick out, but Christian Daigle was right there, forced Elberg inside. Watch here, you see Dag number 99. He doesn't make the tackle, but he makes the play because he forces Elberg back inside. Nice job, and then he lets Brian Wardruff make the tackle.
Now on third and a bunch, Jamie Galloway will kick it away from about his 40. Having a headbutt contest on the Bishop sideline. There's another great punt. Matt Lang from the 15. Looking for room to run, he gets up across the 30 to the 34.
All right, come
Rod Weir up to make the stop. They've settled into a defensive battle. There have been two touchdowns scored in the game, one by the Queens offense, one by Queens special teams. And now Bishops will scrimmage first and 10 from the 35. And, you know, Murphy hasn't thrown the ball badly, but a lot of the times it's been just a couple inches off and his receivers haven't been able to squeeze.
That's really been the difference. You know, he's had people open. Coming across the middle, Masaki Kono a few times, Justin Raymond, he's just got to bring the ball down a little bit.
Under 5 minutes to play in the third quarter. And the give goes to Jeff Roberts, who hits the line running, puts his head down, and he's got about 4 yards to show for it. Mike Boone made the stop.
For the 50-50 draw. Tickets up for the draw after this play.
Take a look at Queens. They don't pass the ball that much, but almost not bad today, you know. But look at Bishops. That's unusual. Normally, they would only be rushing the ball maybe 4 or 5 times in a football game, throwing it a lot more.
That pass almost intercepted by Mark Johnson. The second time in the football game, he's knocked a pass down at the line. In addition, he had that key defensive play on second and goal where he dropped Jim Murphy for a loss.
The bottom of your screen, number 32. Nobody blocks him now. You can't run that play like that. You see Jeff Roberts retreating? No, he's got to step up, and he's got to cut Mark Johnson so that Jim Murphy has a clear view to the receiver.
Punt number 11 for Greg Hiscox. He'll need new shoes after this game. Or at least laces on the one shoe. Another good high punt into this win. Mark Morrison from the 33. Didn't get far as Danny Bohink was right on top of him to make the stop. But how much longer can this Bishop's defense hold?
Okay, the first punt number is 2-2.
They've spent a lot of time on the football field, Jamie.
Yeah, they have spent a lot of time in the field, Gord. You know, this is a pretty good unit. We talked about them all year. They've been overshadowed by the play of their offense in the past. Most people always think of Bishop's offense because they throw ball so well and the kind of people they have playing for them, especially Jim Murphy.
As Mark Johnson had a great day today for Queens. He and Eric Edwards have been the two stars. Brad Elberg with the carry. And Elberg fights his way up before he's brought down by Tom Europe. Got about 5. And if you're just joining us, Brad Elberg turned in the play of the game, and it might be the play of the season for Queens, leading by 2 to open the second half. Elberg took the opening kickoff of the half and took it 95 yards for the touchdown. Elberg, the outstanding running back from Queens, could not be caught by defensive back Tom Europe. That results in the 15-6 lead that Queens enjoys now. Gain of 5, second and 5 from the 45. Pendergast completes it to Elberg, but Elberg is stopped for no gain by Joel Kruzic.
Nice job by Joel Kruzic. He's man-to-man on the first back coming out of the backfield, and that's Brad Elberg. He runs at the call of shallow. Now Elberg has to work back. Kruzic almost slips and makes the great tackle.
A shallow?
Yeah, that's what they call it. You go down 5 yards, you turn it out.
We always called that an out.
I know, well, it's just terminology.
See, I'm learning so much about football this year. The A gap, the A seam.
B seams, B gaps, I know. Stick with me a little longer.
Punt has been an operative word here in the second half. And this one almost hit our scaffolding here. Not too far, and it goes out of bounds. They'll rule it at the 44-yard line, where Bishop will start first and 10.
Well, right now in the third quarter, Bishops are starting to win this punting game here. They're starting to get better field position each time the ball is exchanged. It's Jamie Galloway not happy with that punt.
Yeah. Joe Kruzich, lost for words. First and 10 from the 44 for Bishops. Murphy rolls out. Now throws back against his body. Gets it over there to Alan Baldwin. And they rule it out of bounds. Call is out of bounds. So that'll be second and 10.
Good job by the Bishop's offensive line to allow Murphy to get outside. You see, he gets outside to contain Alouin. Now he turns his shoulders and throws it for Alain Baudouin. It's pretty close. The official right there must have thought he had his foot just on the line.
We talked about Alain Baudouin in our opening and how key he would be for this Bishop's offense. He does not have a catch yet today. Second and 10 from the shotgun. Here's Murphy with time to the flat, and the flag comes down as the pass was intended for Tom Hart, but moving up a little too quickly was Chris McCormick.
Flag down.
And that will be a first down for Bishops.
Murphy looking for Hart. Number 14, Chris McCormick.
A call from Bob Butler.
Legal interference, 14 Queens, first down.
As opposed to the legal interference. Bishops is now in Queens territory, first and 10 from the 53. Perfect. Quick drop. Looking at the flat, the Baudouin picked off. Intercepted by James Patterson. And Patterson is all the way down to the Bishop's 40-yard line, right in front of Coach Ian Breck. Baudouin had it for a moment, but couldn't hang on.
Now this is the case for the receiver. You have to look the ball in the whole way. Watch here, he turns his head, because he knows that Morrison's coming to hit him. Or excuse me, that's Max Turner, and then the ball is into James Patterson's hands.
A huge defensive play for Queens. First and 10 from the 40-yard line. Fake to Elberg, Pendergast, the throw, and it's a one-hopper. He was looking over there for Ed Kidd. Matt Legg provided the coverage. We're at Bishop's University in Lennoxville, Quebec. The Ontario Quebec final for the Dunsmore Cup. The winner goes to the Churchill Bowl next week at Skydome.
Take a look at the total yards, 37 to 28. Bishops has the edge, but Queens have come up with a big play.
But just 65 total yards in offense with 45 seconds to play in the third quarter. Elbert, nowhere. Stacked up by Eric Edwards. Paul Connery and Kent Rao also up to help with the stop. Well, the Bishops defense, give them credit, has stood tall, but James Patterson with a big defensive play just when it appeared that Bishops had some momentum.
Yeah, had some momentum and had good field position. You know, they were starting to win that game of exchanging punts, and they're getting better field position. Now they're going to be back in their own end again.
Dare we call it a chess game for field position? For following the chess motif. 18 seconds and counting to play in the third quarter. The punt by Galloway, high and deep. Misaki Kono mishandled it. Loose ball. He falls on it at the 10. And suddenly Bishops is losing the battle for field position. They've had trouble all day fielding the ball in special teams.
Yeah, and catching the ball downfield. This is so unlike Bishops this year. They've usually been very sure-handed.
Hold him in there, Molly, hold him in there.
Doug Hargrave's talking to his defensive coordinator.
Good way to go, coverage team.
Bob Mullins.
Way to go, folks, way to go, folks.
Apparently Molly will take the blame if they don't. First and 10 from the 10. This should be the final play of the third quarter. Murphy under pressure. Dropped close to a safety, but they'll rule it down at the one. And coming up on the halfback blitz was Aaron Campbell. And that outstanding defensive play typifies what's happened here in this football game.
From the backside, they bring the halfback, Aaron Campbell. No receiver to that side. He comes on the halfback blitz. And
the final play of the third quarter. It's 15 to 6 Queens. One quarter to play, maybe more, but it's Queens up by nine right now.
When life takes an unexpected turn, you want someone right there who'll get the coverage before you need it. An independent insurance broker. Find this symbol and you'll find an independent insurance broker who understands.
Wait! I'm having a snack attack!
Captain Nibbler, to the rescue! With cheese nibblers from McCain, the delicious, nutritious snack that satisfies your sudden hunger as only the taste of real cheese can. McCain makes nibblers from cheddar, mozzarella, Monterey, marble cheese, and convenient single snacks and multi-packs. So when you feel a snack attack coming on, grab a McCain cheese nibbler. Now available in pizza and nachos.
If you hang out with Canada's top builders, you'll see they rely on Makita high-torque tools. Corded or cordless tools, Makita's got the torque to power its way through anything. With over 100 service centers, you'll never get caught with your tools down. Skyscraper or treehouse, Makita makes it easy.
For a limited time, buy this circular saw and get a rebate of $15. Or this Recipro saw and save $20. Details in stores.
When life takes an unexpected turn, you want someone right there who'll get the coverage before you need it. An independent insurance broker. Find this symbol and you'll find an independent insurance broker who understands.
Welcome back to Lennoxville, where it's cool to wear plaid, where it's cool to wear lots of clothes today, because it is chilly. And it is colder on the Bishop sideline. You'd have to expect that last quarterback sack resulted in a loss of 9 yards. It is second and 19 for Bishop from the one. Murphy gets out of the end zone. That's the first trick. It almost intercepted. Are they calling it a catch? Aaron Campbell. And yes, it's a Queens interception. And a flag is down.
The flag was down because Jim Murphy was over the line of scrimmage when he threw the football. So Queens will decline that and take Aaron Campbell's interception.
Campbell with a diving catch. And this will give Queens a first down at the Bishop's 14-yard line. And this crowd in Lennoxville is
stunned. Got a legal forward pass. Number 13 was over the line. Declined. First down.
Jim Murphy looks like he's going to try and run it, but Mike Boone has him snagged. And boy, what a great defensive play by Aaron Campbell to step in front of Jonas Raymond.
It was Campbell who had the quarterback sack that put Bishop back at the one. Well, this is a chance for Queens now to perhaps deliver the knockout punch. First and 10 from the 14. Pendergast goes straight ahead.
I'm not sure what that is unless he had trouble with the snap from center and decided not to try and make a bad thing worse, just kind of falling forward.
Now you wonder with Queens if they're thinking about the leads that got away last year in the OQ final against Bishop, a 30-point lead. The Gators came back to tie it, and of course,
the Churchill Bowl.
A huge lead against Laurier, 20-3. Second and 8, Elbert. Fights his way down to about the 6, but it'll be short of the first down, and it really looked like all the way, Queens would be quite content to kick the field goal. And the field goal would be big. It would make it a 12-point lead for Queens. This a chip shot for Galloway, so I'll throw the curse on him now. From the 14. And Galloway puts it through, so the interception results in 3. It is now an 18-6 lead for Queens over Bishop with 13:26 to play in the fourth quarter.
13:26 to play.
Jamie Galloway, the leading scorer, career scorer in the OQIFC and the leading scorer in Queens history. Puts him on top, 18-6.
This has not been a typical day for Ian Breck's Bishop's Gators. Mentally, they really haven't been sharp at times, and it's really cost them. The Gators will now scrimmage first and 10 from the 35. The light snow is beginning to fall once again. 13:15 to play in the fourth quarter. Claude Sorin, not much.
You know, Gord, there's one guy in the defensive line for Queens that we haven't been talking about very much today, but he's been playing pretty well. That's Eric Dell. He's the lineman of the year in the OQIFC, and will be up for the Metris Trophy in Canada. Number 65.
Dana Ford, second and six. From the shotgun, Murphy. Looking for Tom Hart, but the pass was nowhere close. And a frustrating day continues for Jim Murphy.
You know, you were talking earlier about Queens blowing leads, but I wonder how Bishops feel right now, because they've been in so many key games in the past and they were a great football team, but they can never seem to get to that step to get to the Vanier Cup, take that step to get to the Vanier Cup, and that has to be playing in their minds right now as well.
Hiscox. But it's taken by Mark Morrison. Loose ball, and Queens has it back. It's been an adventure on both sides. But Queens will have the ball back with an 18-6 lead and 12-12 to play in the fourth quarter.
Everybody's different. Different looks, different tastes, different lifestyles. That's why Geo offers you a choice, like the import-inspired Geo Metro, Geo Storm, and Geo Tracker. So pick your favorite and get to know Geo right around the corner at your Chevrolet Geo dealers.
Elsewhere today in the Atlantic final, St. Mary's leads Mount Allison 15-10 in the third quarter. That score is closer than we might have expected. St. Mary's handled Mount Allison pretty easily in a game we did here on TSN. And here's the surprise, Guelph, which upset Western last week, leads Western 21-3 in the third.
That shows you what kind of a defense Guelph have. I mean, they have a good defense, holding Western only to 3 points.
And here it is, Queens leading Bishops 18-6. And they want to get a clean football out there. No play more.
Sign of a good center, Tom Black. Make sure that the ball is dry and cleaned off, no mud on it.
Well, less mud on it. From the 46-yard line, under 12 minutes to play in the fourth. Elbert off tackle, and he's got room to run. It took about four Bishop Gators to bring him down. Joel Kruzich led them with the stop. But not before Elberg had a gain of nine.
They love to run that off tackle, lead with the fullback, and then Elberg, you can see the kind of strength that he has in his legs. Keeps his feet moving. I tell you what, it takes five Bishop Gators to bring him down.
Come on up to the press box to claim your prize.
He shakes a few of the cobwebs out and the mud off of his helmet.
Second and one from the 54. Pendergast gets across the midfield stripe into Bishop's territory for the first down.
Number 10, Tim Pendergast, Keith.
And the Bishop's defense must now feel the heat. The offense has done very little today, and the Gators' defense has stood tall.
Make a fumble, lock the ball.
First and 10 for the Bishops 54. Here's Elberg, and he's got about four that time. Christian Daigh made the stop. But the clock continues to run.
Brad Elberg, an intense football player. Take a look at his eyes before he gets the ball. He's not squinting, he's just an intense guy.
Second and seven for Queens.
And he's over 1,000 yards rushing this year. Of course, playoff games don't count in the final stats. Pendergast. but his pass is well over the head of Steve Jovanovic. That's one of the few times we've seen either quarterback go deep today. And it brings up a third down situation for Queens. Brad Elberg with 72 yards rushing, but what doesn't appear in those numbers, the 95-yard kickoff return for a touchdown to open the third quarter. Galloway to punt. High spiraling kick. It's taken by Masaki Kono at the 10. Kono got away from the first wave of tacklers, but is finally brought down by Don Rorwick. So Bishops has the ball, has a long way to go, and the Gators trail by 12 in the Ontario-Quebec final here in Lennoxville.
Fuel. Play Rocket Fuel Touchdown and you could win up to $25,000.
It takes big plays to win big games, and Doug Hargrave's Queens Golden Gales have turned in the big plays so far today. We'll take you back to the first half and the play by Mark Johnson on second and goal when he sacked Jim Murphy. Then the 95-yard kickoff return for a touchdown by Brad Elbert. That opened the second half. More great defense when Jamie Patterson intercepted this Jim Murphy pass. And then another key interception, this time turned in by Aaron Campbell. As Bishops was stuck deep in its own territory, this resulted in the field goal that gives Queens the 18-6 lead. The Golden Gales enjoy now. So Hargrave's trying to get his team back to the Vanier Cup. The last time Queens won it was back in 1978.
And the last time they were in it was in 1983 versus the Calgary Dinosaurs, a game in which they lost.
Later on today, it is Calgary and UBC for the Hardy Cup in the Canada West. But right now, it is Queens and Bishops. And Bishops scrimmage first and 10 from the 28. Murphy's had a tough day throwing the ball, and he won't get it away here. The ball is loose. And I believe Bishops got it back. Yes, the Gators have it.
Fumble recovered by the Gators.
Well, it has been a rough day all around for Jim Murphy. 5 of 26 passing for 63 yards. He's been intercepted three times and sacked four times.
Not a good afternoon for Jim Murphy. We take a look at Eric Dell, the injured Queens Golden Gale.
From Sudbury, Ontario.
Now, I think Jim Murphy here gave up a Masaki Kono a little bit too soon, because Kono was working outside and he had all sorts of time in the pocket. But then he turns back and he actually had Tom Hart working inside. There were no receivers over on the right side of the field.
That was okay. Second and 16.
The loss was 6. It is second and 16. 9:15 to play in the fourth quarter. Bishops down by 12. And Murphy gets it out in the flat to McCarthy. McCarthy got a good block, gets up across the 26, but he's nowhere close to the first down. He's close to the original line of scrimmage. Coming up next week on TSN, it is doubleheaders Saturday. The Churchill Bowl from Skydome. Danny Bowen and I will be there for that as the champions from the Ontario Quebec and the Ontario Conference meet. John Wells and Leif Pettersson will have the Atlantic Bowl as the champions of the Atlantic meet the winners from Canada West. It all leads to the Vanier Cup in 2 weeks' time here on TSN. Greg Hiscox, again to punt. Mark Morrison from midfield. And not much further. Brian Wardrop makes the stop. But it's good field position for Queens, and there's not much time left for Bishop.
Come on, D, big play.
Well, Gord, you said earlier it's been a game of big plays, and now it's time for Bishop's defense to come up with some big plays here to get their offense on track and get them back into this football game.
Well, Eric Edwards has been the big man on defense today for Bishop's. He'll have to stand tall here again. First and 10 from the 53-yard line for the Golden Gales. Under 8.5 minutes to play in the fourth quarter. Elberg stacked up quickly.
Elberg met by a bunch of commandos.
Joel Kruzich is up to make the stop along with David Henry.
Kruzich, Wardrop sticking their face in his.
The gain was about three.
In the route anyway. We're not getting into his field of vision, so let's get that taken care of, and that's a big part of where we're getting some pressures from the backside, okay?
Trying to sort their offensive troubles out as the Bishop's defense goes to work here against Queen. Second and seven. Kozak, nothing. Eric Edwards makes another big stop. Well, the Bishop's defense did the job.
And, you know, Eric Edwards, you know, that's just great ability to be able to know what's going on right at the time. They're trying to run trap inside. Watch the right guard pull. Eric Edwards comes underneath that. The tap is supposed to come down and drive him across the hole, but he recognizes it so quickly and gets into the hole.
Galloway back to punt once again. But in the battle for field position, Bishop's is losing badly. Three men deep, nine men up for Bishop's. Galloway with a wobbly punt, taken by Kruzich at the 20. And he's stopped in his tracks by Jamie Lewin, number 29. So Bishop's will begin first and 10 from its own 22-yard line. 7:13 to play. In the fourth quarter, it's a 12-point Queens lead.
And we have another scoring from the OUAA Yates Cup final. That is Guelph have just scored before the end of the half to make the score 28-3 for the Guelph Griffins over the Western Mustangs.
Well, last week we saw them in double overtime, or two overtime halves, I guess we'll call it, against the Toronto Varsity Blues. Just two first downs for Bishop's. The wind is blowing and the snow is getting heavier. The toss play to Jeff Roberts. It's a reverse. And here comes Tom Hart. The 33-yard line. He'll be about a yard short of the first down, and Hart is hurt. Well, they talked about backside pressure when we listened in on Ian Breck. That's a good way to alleviate it, the reverse.
Yeah, not bad. Actually, Aaron Campbell, the defensive back, he had check responsibility. He almost makes his play. They run the toss to Roberts. Now he hands it off inside, or excuse me, outside to Tommy Hart. You'll see number 24 of Queens right up top there in the middle of your screen. You have to turn the play back inside.
Second and one from the 33. Murphy's going to throw. He's under pressure. Back into the middle. It's complete there to Alain Baudouin. Baudouin stopped at the 35, but should have the first down. And this passing offense doesn't need any more hurdles to clear, but it is snowing harder here in Lenoxville. The first snowfall of the season couldn't have come at a worse time for the Bishop's Gators.
Number 32, Mark Johnson.
And Mark Johnson is the injured player for Queens that they are attending to. Jim Murphy decides wisely to go over and talk to the coaches in the sidelines. And we see Matt Nealon. He is working with the receivers and the quarterbacks at Bishop's. Remember Matt Nealon, a great receiver from St. Mary's University. All-Canadian for 2 years when he was hooking up with Chris Flynn.
Bishop's better hurry here. Not much time on the clock. 5:50 and counting. First and 10 from the 35 for Bishop's. The Gators need two possessions, and there comes the time count violation as Murphy went to the bench to talk it over. It was too long getting the ball in play. Murphy doesn't like the call since there was an injured player on the field.
Well,
delay a game, number 13, Bishop's.
And he lost the argument.
Call against the Gators, first and 15, backing them up to the 30.
So it's first and 15 from the 30. 5:45 to play in the fourth quarter. Murphy looking to run. Now the pass didn't run, the ball is loose. The ball is loose. And Bishop's got it back. Are they ruling that an incomplete pass?
Or are they just ruling that down? Yeah, I think they're ruling that he's down, and he is still down. I believe that's Jim Murphy.
Yes, it is. Trevor Lovick is the backup quarterback for Bishop's, and he'll hurry to warm up. He's been signaling in plays from the sidelines. And we'll return to Lennoxville in just a moment. You're watching the Ontario-Quebec Final live on TSN.
When you first look at it, you see speed. Looks fast. It's really sharp. The dash, it's like a Boeing 747. Fantastic car. This thing really hugs. This is easy too with this car. The steering's so responsive. This car is fun to drive.
Jim Murphy leaves under his own power. But here's what happened to him.
Well, Jim Murphy realizes nobody's open downfield. He's trying to make something happen. Takes a lot of shots. You can see that's where he gets injured, but I'm sure he'll be back in after one play. As it starts to snow even harder here in Lennoxville.
Trevor Lovick checks in. His season stat, 17 of 28 for 235 yards.
And he's a guy that should be used to these conditions because he played with the Edmonton Huskies junior football out in Alberta.
What are you saying about Edmonton?
They get a lot of snow.
Lovick to throw. And he was looking for Alain Baudouin. New quarterback, same old story for Bishop's. Now, if they play CFL rules, Jim Murphy has to stay out for three plays.
They don't. He would only have to be out for one play. But nevertheless, it was second down. They didn't get it, so Hiscox has to come in once again and kick the ball away.
7 of 28 for 72 yards and three interceptions. A day that Jim Murphy would like to forget. Hiscox punts once again. And it's really coming down now, folks. Mark Morrison from the 45 gets outside. Finally, he's brought down by John Gooby. Flag is down, and that's going against Bishop's. So Queens will have even better field position.
Yeah, Chris Doucette just came in.
And we'll get the call from Bob Murphy.
30 yards on the punt.
Bishop's push from the rear, 5-0.
Chris Doucette gets the call, and it is snowing like a bandit here, folks. Ah, makes me think of home. We talked about it at the start of the game, who the weather would affect the most, the running offense of Queens or the passing offense of Bishop's. 27 punts today. Here's Elbert. Nothing doing. Christian Digg makes the stop. I'll tell you what, this Bishop's defense has done the job today. And Digg does it there. But there's 4:16 to play. And Bishop's is pretty much out of time.
It's a good job by Christian Digg, fending off the block and then just grabbing a piece of Elbert's sweater to haul him down.
I hope you got a windshield wiper. A windshield scraper because I got about an inch of ice on my forehead. Second down from the 44. Pendergast to throw over the head of his intended receiver, Ed Kidd. Kind of bizarre clock management there, Jamie.
Yeah.
You better water those plants there, fellas. Or cover them. There's a frost warning in effect.
Come on, Gators!
What was our tomatoes? Jamie Galloway will come on to punt. That will be the 28th punt of the day. It was an NFL game earlier this year where there were absolutely no punts. And we did a CFL game earlier this season where there were just seven between the two teams. But they've been busy today in bad conditions. High spiraling punt. Matt Legg from the five. Legg looking for room, doesn't find much, gets up to the 15. 3:16 to play in the fourth quarter. Bishops has a long way to go, and you can hardly see across the field with the way the snow is falling now. This is really something.
That's quarterback for the Gators, number four.
They've only had 52 yards in total offense here in the second half. They need to go 95 to score here.
And Trevor Lovig is still in at quarterback. Jim Murphy, who was injured, has not come back in the football game.
Down to 3 minutes. Lovig's pass is knocked down.
Lovig's pass knocked down.
I think that was Mike Boone.
Second down.
He's got his hand on it.
Now, this is a situation where you would think that the Bishop's offense would go to shotgun or have that spread formation where they can just sit Lovig back about 5 yards, directly snap the ball to him, so he doesn't have to worry about dropping back and planting his feet, because the conditions of this field are starting to deteriorate even more. Getting pretty slick on top.
On second down, Lovig steps up. And what a defensive play that was by Max Turner, who dove across to knock that ball down. The pass was intended for Jonas Raymond. You know, Jamie, we talked about the key receivers for Bishops. Baudouin has one catch. Raymond has one. The only man with more than one is Tom Hart. He's got two. Hiscox to punt. End over end. Bounces at about the 40. This is Mark Morrison. Not much, but he didn't need much. He's brought down at the 45, 2:31 to play in the fourth quarter.
Number 24, Eric Campbell having
trouble. Oh, it's been like you read about here in the last 10 minutes.
First and 10, Queens at the 45.
They could run the Iditarod here today.
Well, I think we're going to need a shovel up here in the booth in a few moments. Ian Breck hoping that his offense can finally get something going.
Albert, oh, big gain, a first down, and he's finally brought down there by Joel Kruzic.
Number one, Brad Albert for the first down.
You know, Ian Breck has to be pleased with how his defense has played. It's been the lack of his offense, and now the defense has to come up big once again to get the ball back. The Bishops with 2:26 remaining.
And a flag is down on the play as well. Just what Bishops needed. And the penalty will move it all the way down to about the 15-yard line. Hard to see that far. Jingle bells, jingle bells. 2.5 to go in the fourth quarter. Hellberg with the carry again inside the 10.
By number 97, Ricky Harris.
I tell you, Queens really love to run off tackle. And then they just let Brad Albert, to give him the ball deep in the backfield, and they let him read the blocks, and if he sees an opening inside, he just cuts it back.
21st carry of the game for Brad Albert, who was approaching 100 yards rushing. He's got 91. If he gets 9 more, he'll be pretty close to putting his team in the end zone. Here he comes again. Elberg inside the 5.
Number one, Brad Elberg, the ball carrier.
But most importantly, the clock continues to run.
And you know, they continue to run behind Mark Robinson, number 62, the big offensive tackle for Queens. 6'2", 285 against Christian Dagg, 6'4", 255.
And they're down to the 4-yard line. 1:50 and counting to play in the fourth quarter. Elbert loops it around outside, cuts it back in, and he is stopped at about the 3.
76, David Henry making the play along with Danny.
1:39 to play in the fourth quarter, and the Bishop's Gators, who have never been to the Vanier Cup, won't be going this year.
Brad Elberg, realizing off tackle's not there, tries to take it outside. Now he tries to cut, and you can see all the turf coming up. His knee touches the ground, and the official blows it dead.
DMA.
Well, a bad hair day, but a good football day for the Queens Golden Gales. Second down, Elberg. Touchdown, Queens. Brad Elberg in for the score. 24-6 with a convert to come. And the Queens Golden Gales can celebrate in the snow because next week they'll be playing indoors at Skydome. And Brad Elberg has been a major part of the story.
When we talk about how they like running off tackle, you see Paul Kozan, the lead back. He just takes on John Gooby, number 11, and just a little bit of a seam in there for Elberg to get into the end zone. One of the top running backs in the CIAU. All great running backs can sniff the goal line. Brad Elberg's no different.
Kick is good. Nailed 25, Gators 6.
Doug Hargraves has his Queens Golden Gales back to the Churchill Bowl, and they can try to avenge what happened to them last year against the Loree Golden Hawks. Well, he's not a fan of the Eskimos, but you might want to be one out here today. And Brad Elberg has gone over 100 yards rushing. Tack on the 95-yard kickoff return he had for a touchdown, and that's an outstanding day. 1:17 to play in the fourth quarter. The Bishop's Gators will lose only one game this season. Their last game, their playoff game. It doesn't take long for this snow to accumulate on the field. As the Queens band has started to play again, perhaps not by choice, their instruments may be frozen to their lips. Oh, you got to feel for Ian Breck, don't you, Jamie?
Yeah, you really do. You know, he's had one of the best programs. Bishops have had one of the best programs the last number of years, even when Bruce Coulter was here. Bruce Coulter, now the retired coach, head coach, who's back on the staff. Ian Breck has done a great job this program, but
this is Tom Hart from the 20. And now there's some pushing and shoving right in front of the Queens bench. One of the players involved is Kent Rao, number 78 from Bishops.
And no question, that's frustration on the behalf of Bishops. You go through an undefeated season, you don't lose a game all season long, and it comes to the Dunsmore Cup, the final, and you realize you're not going on anymore. Your season ends right now. See Tom Hart trying to fight his way, loses his helmet on that hit.
Under a minute to play and the clock will run. Jim Murphy is back in at quarterback for the Bishop's Gators. He'll work out of the shotgun. 45 seconds and counting to play, and Murphy goes out to the sidelines and one hops that one.
Murphy's pass incomplete, looking for number 20, Tom Hart.
Time to celebrate on the Queens sidelines. 41 seconds still, they can go back to their dressing room. And they've played their last game outdoors this year. The snap goes over Murphy's head. He's kicking it towards the end zone. Closer in, ran right over it. Queens recovers it at the 1. What a day for the Queens Golden Gales. Another great defensive play has turned in. And I don't think Murphy was expecting the ball.
Kind of a day it's been for Bishop. You can see Jim Murphy looking to his right, and the ball is snapped. Chris Doucette, then Murphy kicks it, hoping that Claude Sorin can recover it in the end zone, maybe for a two-point safety.
Fifth turnover of the game by Bishop. And so now with 20 seconds and counting to play in the fourth quarter, the offense will finish it out for Queens, but it's the defense that has done the job today. And in is the backup tailback, Don Rorwick. Rorwick with the touchdown.
Number 35.
A little window dressing. It's 31-6 with a convert to come. Brad Elbert got his 100 yards rushing, and now Rorwick has a touchdown.
Jamie Galloway to try the extra point.
And these 11 seconds can't go fast enough for Ian Breck now, who will have a whole offseason to think about a 7-0 regular season and the playoff loss to Queens. And you know what, folks? It stopped snowing, kind of. Doug Hargrave, 17 years. And he's got his team headed back to the Churchill Bowl. So they'll kick it off, probably run one more play, and that will do it. The Queens Golden Gales will head over to the Sky Dome, down the 401 from Kingston. And they're going for the second year. There's a bit of a delay here as they get some things sorted out in the field, but now Galloway will kick it off.
Galloway to kick off.
And they're running the clock mercifully. So this will be the final play of the football game. Masaki Kono with the kickoff return. He's brought down at the 40. And that is the end of the football game. The Queens Golden Gales defeat the Bishop Gators 32-6. It's off to Sky Dome for the Golden Gales, the champions of the Ontario-Quebec Conference for 1992. We'll come back with our TSN turning point, the player of the game, in a moment.
Check the map.
Cancel that order, guys.
All right.
Yeah.
Let's eat. You want a Coke? No, I'm making a Pepsi.
Well, what's the diff?
You said that.
The difference is one tastes better.
This one.
You chose Pepsi.
The majority of soft drink users tested prefer the taste of Pepsi over Coke Classic.
You want sausage or pepperoni?
What's the diff?
I've guaranteed the Remington Microscreen shaves as close as a blade or your money back. Our customers agree. We surveyed over 100,000 new Microscreen owners about the closeness of their previous shaving method, including blades. Remington shaves as close as a blade or your money back. And for overall shaving satisfaction, Remington was the clear winner. Remington has 120 diamond-honed cutting edges and two flexible ultra-thin screens. Look, the first screen shaves close and gently stretches the skin, lifting the whiskers so the second screen can actually shave below skin level. Quick, smooth, comfortable. The Remington Microscreen shaves as close as a blade or your money back. Now you can get this exceptional value Remington Microscreen shaver for this low, low price.
When you're busy being a mom and chauffeur, the last thing you're thinking about is your brakes, right? But if something told you they weren't right, would you know where to go? You don't want to trust them to just anybody, so you go to Midas.
I'm just a love machine, and I won't work for nobody but you. I'm just a love machine.
Hey, Duracell, you can't talk the copper talk.
Now for the TSN TSN Turning Point, which is brought to you by Sony, and it's no surprise.
Gordon, in the opening kickoff in the second half with Queens leading 8-6. They kick it to Brad Ober. He starts right, then he cuts back left, and he takes it 95 yards for the touchdown, putting this game out of reach for the Bishop Gators.
That's the TSN Turning Point. A cash donation will be made to the Coaching Association of Canada for the training and development of Canadian coaches in amateur sport. On behalf of TSN and Sony, Sony Trinitron XBR Square. It will change the way you feel about everything you see. And our Geo Player of the Game, Brad Elbrick, joins us now. Brad, you had two kickoff returns this year for 62 yards. You had one in this game for 95. Were you surprised you had that much room?
I wasn't surprised that we had that much room. The guys did a fabulous job making a wall, and when you don't get touched all the way down the field, it's pretty easy to score.
Brad, your team comes down to Bishop's. You're facing a hostile crowd, tough weather conditions, and you come up with a win. What was the key today?
I think the key today was everybody on our team playing 60 minutes. The defense did a fabulous job shutting down. They got a high-power offense, and I don't think 6 points is what they counted on scoring today, so you got to credit the defense. I did a fantastic job, and the offense did it when we had to.
Brad, congratulations, and we'll see you next week at the Churchill Bowl.
Right on. Thanks a lot, guys.
And as Brad Elbrick is our player of the game, Gio will contribute $500 to the scholarship fund of his school, Queen's University. The final score, Queen's 32, Bishop 6. Back to Lennoxville in a moment on TSN.
Imagine visiting yourself in the future.
Wow, look who's here.
I know you.
Sure do. I'm you 25 years later.
What am I doing here?
We spend our winters here.
Did we win the lottery?
No lottery. Freedom 55.
Only your London Life representative offers Freedom 55. Protection today, plus a financial plan that works, so one day you won't have to.
And when did we start driving convertibles?
About the same time we started surfing.
Surfing?
Are you still living with this nightmare? Over a million motorists have said never again. They've switched to Triple Edge, and the difference is amazing. Triple Edge is the world's first high-tech windshield wiper. It clears, it cleans, it wipes dry, all in a single pass. But that's not all. Triple Edge wipers won't tear, dry rot, or freeze to your windshield. They're made from DuPont Nordel, the same material used in 50,000-mile radial tires. Triple Edge gives you visibility through the heaviest downpour. It whisks away snow and ice. Even mud is no match for Triple Edge.
The day after I got my Triple Edge wipers, we had a big snowstorm with blowing sleet and wind. Everybody had trouble seeing except me. My visibility was beautiful.
No noise, no streaking, no smearing, no tearing. Custom fit to install in seconds. They're the last windshield wipers you'll ever buy. Triple Edge is available at participating Woolco, London Drugs, Home Hardware, Overweighty and Save On Foods, Beaver Lumber, and Kmart.
Did you see that?
What?
Now you must have seen that.
What?
Now when you come to McDonald's,